as we head into the weekend, beach safety may be on your mind after Saturday's shark attack in Southern California. A long-distance swimmer survived the bite from a 7-foot great white. In our report a couple years ago, we showed you the first great white to be caught, tagged, and released in North America. Spot tagged, it's the work of O-Search, a team of fishermen and scientists who created new ways to study the behavior of the species. O-Search founder and expedition leader Chris Fisher is here again this morning. Chris, good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
When this attack happened last weekend, I saw you tweet out there were a lot of misleading headlines. What happened?
Well, I think what you have here is a situation where a lot of human activities happening in the same area shouldn't be. You know, it doesn't really pass the common sense test to be shark fishing where people are swimming and surfing. And so you have an unfortunate event where a baby white shark, a 7-foot white shark that's probably only a few years old, is fighting for its life and it gets tangled up with a swimmer.
For 30 or 40 minutes.
Yeah, for 30 or 40 minutes. So this is really not something that's normal. We see juvenile white shark nurseries around the world in places like Australia and South Africa, and we don't typically see any sort of human shark interaction in those areas.
Yeah, the swimmers at the time were really ticked off at the fishermen because they said they agitated the sharks. The sharks normally would not bother you. Is that true?
Well, I think everybody can improve on their decision making there. If you know people are fishing, you don't need to be swimming through that area. If you know people are swimming through an area, you don't need to be fishing in that area. So here we have a couple of humans making decisions that collide that impact the shark.
Why is the great white shark population exploding?
Well, in Southern California, it's exploding because we've had success with regulations in the 90s. We banned the capturing of sharks in 97. We got some of the inshore gill nets out in the early 90s. And now, 20 years later, we're starting to see success. A lot more juvenile sharks in Southern California, which is a white shark nursery. We learned that from our work out there.
Well, then that makes people say, is it safe for me to be at the beaches?
Yeah, a white shark nursery is a very safe place to be. You see juvenile sharks, they're eating a lot of rays, they're eating a lot of fish, and don't typically interact with humans. And once they become mature, that 12 to 14 foot range, they head offshore and don't typically return.
Ah, so it's the baby sharks would be dangerous to humans.
They are not dangerous to humans, the baby sharks. It's the mature sharks, which we don't find on the beaches of Southern California very often.
And you don't seem to be afraid of them, Chris. Why?
Well, look, we need these sharks there. I mean, this is a great success story. There will be more fish off the Pacific coast because there are more white sharks. They'll help handle the seal population out there, and things will come into balance. They are the lion of that system and keep it in balance. So it's important to see them recover.
More sharks on the West Coast, more white sharks on the East Coast as well?
Similar thing happening on the East Coast, just maybe a little bit further behind, a decade behind. We also got a lot of gear types out of Southern Florida and the East Coast back in the early 90s, which has led to more success in the nursery of the white sharks. We're starting to see a lot more sightings in Florida of smaller white sharks, which then as they grow and mature leads to mature white sharks, which we're now seeing up off Cape Cod, where we've done a lot of work together.
And you've tagged Mary Lee and Catherine. I love that you give them such pretty names. I love this. What are you looking for? What are you trying to discover from them?
Well, it's very exciting. You know, right now, Mary Lee, which we tagged about 2 years ago off of Cape Cod, has been now tracked for almost 2 years. This will be the first full 2-year mature female Atlantic white shark migration in history. And within her track lies the breeding site and the birthing site for the first time in history. She's been off the southeast. She has an area where she looks like she's been gestating. She started to head in toward Hilton Head Island. She could very well give birth there and then proceed back to Cape Cod. And if she does that by August or September, she will confirm that that is the North Atlantic breeding site.
So many things are fascinating about this. First, 15,000 miles she traveled. Mm-hmm. And also, she's 40 to 50 years old. And she's gestating.
She's gestating, 18-month gestation period. You know, Mary Lee is a real veteran. She's a mature shark who's made this migration of 2 years a number of times. A recent study coming out of Massachusetts let us know that these white sharks aren't sexually mature until they're approximately 20 and can live well over 70. Mary Lee is a big, mature female who knows what she's doing.
And so has she had babies before?
Oh, many times, every other year. She should have babies between 2 and 20.
So are you going to go hook up with her again and to see her have these babies?
Our tracking device wouldn't allow us to get, like, right on her like that. You know, what we do is we look at the rhythm of her migration. Mm-hmm. 18 months after we tagged her, she should be giving birth.
And she hooks up with a male shark?
Oh, wow.
Have you ever actually seen how they mate?
No one has ever seen that. The first thing we've done is identify where and when they're breeding, which then will give us an opportunity to then film and document.
No one's seen how they actually do it. You curious?
We're all curious.
We're curious.
Everyone's curious. Chris Fisher, fascinating. So great to have you back.
Yeah.
Keep us posted.
It's always good to see you.